Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, it's both an honor and a privilege to welcome each of you to the 49th National Meeting of this association here at this beautiful Santa Bel Harbor Marriott here in Fort Myers, Florida. As always, I'd like to personally thank all of the newcomers and welcome here to welcome in you into the USSSA family. I would also like to thank each and every one of you have put forth the time, dedication, and commitment necessary to help make USSSA the largest multi-sport organization in the country. The dedication of this board, our vice presidents, the staff, and directors are unmatched throughout the industry. This week begins a new chapter in our illustrious 49-year history as we finally achieved our goal. January 1, we can officially call Brevard County Space Coast Stadium in Viera, Florida, our new home. Renovations of the existing stadium, baseball quad, and 18,000 square foot of office and training facility will begin in the next few weeks, transforming this former major spring training site, Major League Baseball Complex, into the state-of-the-art, all-turf, multi-sport facility that will host our most prestigious events for all ages. When it's all said and done, this facility will feature an 8,100-seat stadium, 11 suites, a 225-foot championship field, and four 225 NCAA regulation fields, four 325 baseball, softball quads, four 385 NCAA regulation baseball fields. The 18,000-square-foot indoor facility will be for training, rehabilitation, and clinics. A 175-foot field for our 8-year-olds and our younger ones to have their championship field with a video board. 1.3 million square foot of turf. The newest LED technology lighting with all concessions around all the facilities. We will now have total control over every single weekend throughout the year, and even better, it will give us an opportunity to be able to ensure our gate, fees, concessions, souvenirs are affordable for our families that attend our events. We're taking care of the membership 365 days a year. Shortly after January 1st, the construction will begin in full swing, and we plan to move national headquarters and staff to the new facility in mid-April. Unlike the Astros, we won't abandon Osceola County. We have no plans to follow their suit. We will be moving national headquarters, but USSSA will still have a large presence in Osceola County, and we continue to fulfill our current contract that we have already discussed plans to continue utilizing their facilities for the future years. To enhance this facility, we are pleased to announce we're in finalization of our partnership with the Major League Baseball Players Association. This agreement will not only give the MLBPA a year-round presence at this new facility to help train and educate future players, it will also give the MLBPA the opportunity to reach today's youth players throughout sponsorship of our select 30 baseball programs. It's a true win-win. Former players will be able to continue to make a positive impact on today's youth, many of whom will be tomorrow's MLB stars. This, along with professional players, the NPF players, our USSSA Florida Pride, which are the best women players in the country, in the world, we now will combine the two pros, which will be around this facility 365 days a year, making this facility quite exciting to all competition of people, the teams that want to play them out. I'm going to recognize the Pride right now because the ladies are here. Some of them are coaching, some of them are in Japan, but a good flow of them are right here right now. And this team this year was put to a real test because in our eighth year, this was our eighth year, it was 11 new girls on the team, which we never added anybody like that. So it was a brand new squad. They had to get together. They had to have chemistry. We put them on the road because the Pride does their best when they're on the road. And that's why we got involved. They spread the word. They give our flag. They give our presence to our fast pitch program. They're around the game. We put them on the road for, I think, 21 of the first 23 days they were playing. I think they played like something, their 50-game schedule, maybe in 60-some days. We'd really test them. We wouldn't start until after the College World Series. We started late because we don't believe in playing during the College World Series. That's the finest event around for college players, and the Pride wouldn't do that. So we put them on. They went to the All-Star game. They were with MLB. They were on the stage. They were on Major League Baseball. Major League Baseball seen what they bring to the game. Social media was at the highest. All of our followers, the Pride is, we believe, America's team. And they did all this, and they had the best record in the history of not only the Pride at 41-14, the best record ever in the NPF. I'd like to give a big hand to these ladies over here that came here this weekend. So to say this has been a whirlwind year would be an understatement. We're looking towards the future of both baseball and softball. When we were sending people internationally, this resulted in an invitation to Rome to meet with the World Baseball Softball Confederation President Ricardo Vaccari. Little do we know, this meeting could open many doors. USSSA is in the process of finalizing our associate membership with the World Baseball Softball Confederation. This will allow us to offer sanctioned international events and even the possibility of hosting future World Cups in baseball and softball. Our willingness to send both professional softball players and baseball players on these international trips has culminated in USSSA being the official training and develop organization for 182 countries for baseball. Now, with the facility and having professional baseball players and professional softball players working year-round, there'll be quite a bit of them doing some international and probably a lot of participation internationally. We believe that over there is, and today we have some of our friends from Italy and from Mexico here, and I'd like to, it's a good time to introduce them. And DJ Wabek, who is our international VP, has opened some of these doors. He's been on this project, and he's done a great job at leading us through, and he's brought these friends with us, and they are great people. First of all, for the first time ever, I'm going to announce our first new vice president. He's not present right now. His daughter has an appendectomy, and she's in the hospital. But it's Andrea Dioria, and his wife is here, Lila, and son Nicole, and the son Josh, and his daughter Nicole, Alessandro, and Mabel, and Valerie Balaratme. Alessandro Tomasi and Francesca. They're from the WBSC. And Sergio Blasi from Mexico are here. Let's give them a big hand and welcome them to USSSA. And we have another new gentleman that we appointed this year, and he's going to head up our basketball program, James Taylor. Where's James at? That program is going to blow things away right now. James is now taking over our basketball program. For the last 15 years, USSSA has been on the cutting edge of technology, separating ourselves and keeping us ahead of our competition. Later today, we'll unveil the biggest technological advancement in USSSA history, a project that has taken over 4,000 hours and over 500 full days of work to complete, focusing on the needs of our directors to run a successful program. At this time, I'd like to thank the IT committee for their continued work on this project. A special thanks to Bob Edgar, who's not here right now. His mom passed away. Bob is the chair of that committee, and he done a fabulous job over these last of trying to make our key know what we needed in the field. The other people we'll talk about later on, and they're all awesome, and I'll introduce them later. Several years ago, we've been an overhaul of the public website. The work continues daily, and we have implemented several new features to enhance our customers now. The experience, including getting into single events, landing pages. Personally, I believe the Guardian program that was implemented this year, along with the development of the player locker, which is available to all USSSA participants at no cost, allow USSSA maintain our competitive edge. These player lockers will now give individual players, not just teams, the tools they need for their continued success. Evaluations, recruiting, history. College coaches are drooling over this tool that they now will not have to run field to field. They could press a button and see who the best players are from Division I all the way down to NAI and whatever. Everybody's going to have a shot now to see our athletes. USSSA and our directors rely heavily on the support of our sponsors and sporting goods manufacturers. In true partnership form, they have asked and we have listened. Exciting things are ahead for us together to prepare a launch, a program that would allow USSSA members to receive discounts and sporting goods equipment and apparel from the manufacturers on one site. In addition, USSSA members will also have access to discounts on other training and specialty items. In true championship form, USSSA is now taking care of its directors, its teams, its players, sponsors, and partners. That's a true grand slam. Almost as exciting as the one Addison Russell, former USSSA player, hit in the World Series. Let's take a look at some highlights from this year.
Big group out here, they get a chance to have a unique experience with the tryout. We as professional athletes get to score them. They have that kind of one-on-one insight at what they need to be better at, what they already are succeeding at, and what it's going to take for them to get to the next level.
Only at this time of year will we get to go face pitching and the level of competition that you see in an event like this.
It just gets me pumped and ready to play. Like, woo! I'm just so excited.
The tailgate was really cool, seeing like all the vendors and like even meeting some of the NPF girls like Kaylani Ricketts and Lauren Chamberlain.
USSSA is starting off 2016 with some exciting news. The Field of Dreams out in Brevard County officially opened Tuesday, January 5th.
Playing baseball is just another day for Nelia Peralta.
I've been doing this for a long time and don't really want to stop. I love the field. Always want to be out on the field.
Over 100 teams are here at the Canton Super NIT in Canton, Michigan.
Kavita Schnee here at the University of Miami for the Adidas All-American Showcase Camp, powered by MLB.com, where players 9 to 14 get a chance to improve their game and also be seen and evaluated by some of the best in the business. Also tonight, they get to compete. Let's go.
And you take a look at what was done in Tuscaloosa. It was really like nothing fast pitch had ever seen before.
It's something new. It's something that our game hasn't really seen. Take out everything. Take out who they play for. Take out what they've done in the games in the past. These were their 2 days to show up, to compete, to showcase, you know, who they were as an athlete.
The NPF welcomes you to San Diego. MLB is here for the All-Star Weekend, and the USSSA Pride and the Dallas Charge have arrived as well early this morning. They're at the San Diego Convention Center taking part in the MLB Fan Fest, meeting the youngsters and handing out tickets to tonight's contest here at Fowler Park. How big is it for these MLB players to see this Pro Fast Pitch League be a part of MLB All-Star Weekend?
Well, it's great that they're kind of bringing the two together. I mean, there's common respect on both sides, and it's just a fantastic thing to see how much this sport has grown.
So the best team, you're looking at them in the National Pro Fast Pitch League out of Florida, the USSSA Pride out here, and we are certainly glad to have all of you.
Every summer, the nation's top softball sluggers travel the country showcasing their power while they battle for the nationwide conference USSSA championship.
New headquarters for USSSA at the Space Coast Stadium. It is undergoing at least $12 million in renovations, and by the time it's finished, it could be more. How will that impact this conference?
Well, it's going to be huge. Having a facility of our own
Beautiful stadium, 8,000 seats with all the amenities. I think it's going to take it, and now we're going to probably do some a lot of training and a lot of different things that we can do to help the younger guys see what's going on here. So I think it's going to really grow all the sports. We're heavy into youth, and I think the youth are going to grow, and I think that's the basis of our business, is we're going to be around for a long time.
Leave it all on the field.
Yes.
Give me the green light.
Oh, yeah.
Cause I'm ready to go. Let's have a good time.
Let's go.
What you waiting for? You only got one life.
One life.
So we gon' live it up. So give me the green light. Cause I'm ready to go.
Good job, Bernie. Today, let's please take advantage of the opportunity each of you have this week to network with other directors, the staff, and USSSA sponsors. Much of this week's focus will be on training. In addition to the mandatory training workshops today and Thursday, there will also be opportunities for additional assistance on Wednesday and Friday. Use this week to learn all you can learn in order to enhance your programs. I trust that when you leave this week's meeting, you will be excited about the future of USSSA, as I am, and eager to use the tools that you've been given in order to grow the organization. The association right now is in a good place. And as far as the opportunities right now for everybody in here, the timing couldn't be any better. You're going to need to use the system. And there's going to be a lot of opportunities now, and there's a lot of growth. There's going to be a lot of new programs and a lot of new VPs and a lot of new things. But you're not going to be able to use the system, and you're not going to be part of the upper echelon unless you get to this system. So you got to use it. We can't stress how much there is that you got to have this system. There's just too much money and time to make your job easier. It's not fair to the membership. It's not fair to anybody. Use the system. We got the tools out there for you. It's going to be unbelievable what you see. So on behalf of the board of directors and myself, I wish each and every one of you a successful week and an enjoyable meeting. Now it's time to get to work. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Don. As I mentioned earlier, there is no constitutional amendments proposed.
I have some announcements here that I'd like to give you. There will be a fellowship gathering tomorrow morning at 7:30 a.m. At the poolside by the Cove area. If you're interested in golf or the cornhole event tomorrow, day for golf, the evening for the cornhole, you can go to the registration desk and register for that if you would like to. And I think there are a few openings available in both. I have no other further announcements. Anybody else have anything here? Meeting's adjourned. Promptly back here at 10:30. Very important.